करना
Okay, we have been discussing steady flow energy equation. The steady flow energy equation is applicable on which type of systems, open system or closed system. We have been discussing steady flow energy equation and steady flow devices and some devices. Which system?
Open system, sir.
Open system. So, what do you mean by open system? This is just to. Recollect things and convey things with your friends. Okay, what do you mean by open system? An open system is the one where both mass and energy cross the system. So, in order to better understand thoroughly about the concept of steady flow energy equation. Or about the steady flow energy equation. To familiarize with the steady flow energy equation, we are as and when required for a particular device. After it is discussed, a problem we will consider, and in that way you will be made thorough with this equation. In no time, you will apply this equation to any device. So, what is the example or steady flow device discussed in the last class? The steady flow energy equation was applied on which type of steady flow device? In the last class, we discussed a steady nozzle. Steam nozzle or whatever it is, nozzle. And we consider gas turbine or steam turbine or air turbine, whatever it is, or water turbine, whatever it is. But in general, we call this device as turbine. What is the purpose of a turbine? See, actually here, the figure has been drawn like this, but you have to draw, see, showing inlet on the left side and outlet on the right side. Inlet at left side and outlet at the right side. So this is an expanding device. See, whenever air or gas or steam enters at lowest cross section, and it leaves the larger cross section at its other end by expanding to it. And okay, what is the purpose of any turbine, whether it is gas turbine or steam turbine, whatever it is, what is the purpose of a turbine? Quick, you need not go through, see what all given here in sentence form. You need not go through. I told you several times not to focus on those sentences. Instead, you focus on the figure and how it is drawn, and in what way we can draw the figure in a more simple manner. Like that you have to focus on the figure, and then you have to focus on any equation is there, you have to focus on it. Now I am asking you, what is the purpose of a turbine? You have been answering this question since long back. You have already answered many days back. The purpose of a turbine is you are not audible, some noise is coming. Okay, the purpose of a turbine is quick. Is it a power consuming device or power producing device? A turbine is okay. Remember that a turbine produces energy, produces power. A turbine produces power. How it produces? It may be a water turbine, it may be a gas turbine, it may be a steam turbine, whatever it is. That fluid expands through the turbine, and power will be developed. How it is developed? You will see these practical things in the coming semesters. But briefly, we discuss here. The shaft of the turbine is coupled to a generator-like. And whenever a fluid enters the turbine at inlet, and the rotor inside it, it rotates with very high speed, and in that way, the energy of the gas or energy of steam or energy of water is utilized by the rotor. The rotating part, of course, is named with some other name in depending on the device, and that rotor is connected to, is coupled to a generator which gives power, and this is of course connected to electrical grid. So there from there we get power. So in that way, a turbine is a power producing device. So whenever a device is shown to you, or whenever a device is there, you have to understand or identify the very purpose of that device. Earlier we discussed and we have taken one device, that is a nozzle. what is the purpose of an Azure? I am again raising the doubt, because to habituate ourselves to be familiar with the purposes of these simple devices. Nozzle purpose. What is the nozzle purpose?
To increase velocity.
That's all. Now, what is the purpose of turbine?
To produce energy.
To produce power. Or you can say to produce power in general.
Okay, sir.
The turbine is drawn here, but you have to draw this in the reverse way. That is a divergent path like this, and at the outlet a generator is connected. See, however, the figure is shown here like this. In whatever way you draw, here steam or gas enters at the lowest cross section area of the turbine, that is called inlet. And what happens, the energy of the fluid is utilized by the rotor. And what is rotor? This is the turbine. Is not this much simple as we are discussing here. Actually, in practice, there are several wheels on the rotor, and there are the several blades on the rotor. Surrounding the rotor, there are several blades like fan blades, and the entire rotor, now it will rotate with very high speed of the order of thousands of RPM. And when this rotor is coupled to a generator, then this will produce this will be converted into electrical energy. So here, in that way, the mechanical energy produced by the turbine is converted into electrical energy by generator, of course. So in that way, whatever energy is producing, or whatever power is produced by the turbine, that is captured and that is stored in the generator. That is, by coupling the turbine with a generator, or sometimes this is also called alternator. And this will produce power. The electrical power will be produced. So in that way, here the turbine will produce mechanical energy, and that is converted into power, electrical power. So in that way, a turbine is a power producing device. What happens here? Here, the high pressure steam or gas and is utilized here to rotate the rotor, and the high pressure is utilized and the pressure drops here. So here at this point, pressure will be higher, and at outlet, pressure will be lower, and that pressure will be stored in the steam or gas enthalpy. Sometimes you call the total energy enthalpy. So that is being utilized by the rotor for gaining the rotation, high speed rotation. And at the outlet, there will be steam or gas that is going out with a lower pressure. So that is the story of the turbine. And how the energy equation or steady flow energy equation is applied. On all the devices, we have applied two equations. One is steady flow equation, that is continuity equation, which is m dot in equal to m dot out. That is the rate at which mass enters in m dot in equal to m dot out, the rate at which mass leaves out of the device. That means there will be no accumulation of mass within the device at any time. At any time, there is no accumulation of mass. So that is what steadily the fluid flows steadily. Steadily means with respect to time, whatever mass enters, that much mass will leave. That is what steady flow. And energy equation we had the energy terms h1 plus c1 square plus gz1 plus q equal h2 plus v2 square by 2. H2 plus c2 square by 2 plus gz2 plus w. This is entire equation, and here, because while flowing, here a generalization has been made. While the steam flows through the turbine, there may be rejection of heat from the turbine valve here, from the like this. There like this. Rejection of heat is shown, and this is all in this is not a generalization. This is a case where heat rejection is given. So heat rejected is negative. So therefore, instead of plus Q, it is shown minus Q. And of course, you can even put plus Q, and the numerical value, if it will be given in negative terms. For example, the turbine rejects say 10 kilojoules per second of heat, then we have to use minus 10 here. Minus 10 into 1000. I told you the sign convention for heat and work. And because this is work producing device, here plus W is of course written, and this W is can be found by incorporating the numerical values of these parameters: H1 enthalpy at inlet, H2 enthalpy at outlet. If it is, for example, a steam case, here if pressure and temperature are given, if it is a superheated steam, then enthalpy can be read from steam table. And similarly, if pressure and temperature at outlet given, enthalpy will be read from steam table. In this, or if it is air or gas, enthalpy can be worked out. That means the values of H1, H2 can be found if air is flowing into the machine, the turbine. If air is flowing, then we would write H1, H2 as Cp into T1 or Cp into T2. Because for an ideal gas, enthalpy is a function of temperature, and it is CpdT. dH is equal to CpdT. So in this way, a turbine problem can be handled. See, a steady flow energy equation, putting Z1 equal to Z2, all the times, the axis of the rotor as the reference, then at this taking this as one reference and ground level as other reference. Now the mass enters at inlet is at the same level as mass leaves at the outlet. In that way, Z1 equals Z2. And for almost all the steady flow devices, we consider Z1 equal to Z2, but it is not a generalized one. If any datum given, any different datums are given, we have to apply the steady flow energy equation as per the given I told you. We consider a problem for that device. See here, in a gas turbine, the gases flow through the turbine is 10 kg per second. So mass flow rate given. The power developed by the turbine is 12,000 kilowatts. The enthalpies of gases at inlet and outlet given. So H1, H2 directly given. So in this way, a steady flow problem is a very easy problem to tell you, and you can do this problem that much easier. And see, power developed by turbine given 12,000, the enthalpies are given this many, H1, H2, and the velocities of gases at inlet and outlet given. Here, what we considered here, velocities are also considered, but however, it is dependent on the problem. Here, because velocities are given, we take velocity. If suppose velocities are cited in the problem as equal at inlet and outlet, we can consider C1 equal C2. But here, C1 equal to 50 given, 50 meter per second given, C2 equal to 110 meter per second given. Now, we have to calculate the rate at which heat is rejected to the turbine. And that means Q dot. And the area of the inlet pipe, ET to be found. For that, the specific volume of the gases at inlet given, 0.45 meter cube per kg given. So, see, the second part of the problem is, of course, it is not a direct substitution. But the first part of the problem, that is Q, the first part requires the calculation of Q, and it is you can substitute directly in this equation. Enthalpy is H1, H2 given. See, and these are to be substituted in joules per kg or joules per kg. And C1, C2 meter square, C1, C2 in meter per second, you have to substitute. And heat rejected will be in joule per kg. If this is written for unit mass basis, and for this case, these terms that are, say, for example, Q per unit mass and W per unit mass. That means this Q and W here are in joule per kg. But whereas the power is given in 12,000 kilowatt, so 12,000 multiplied by 10 cube watts. What means joule per second? So this is given as a total unit. That means m dot multiplied by work done per or work developed by per unit mass. So m dot is in kg per second, work developed per unit mass in joule per kg. So the combined unit is divided by kg per second, that is the rate at which the flow of gases in kg per second that are entering the device. See here, all the given information is given, mass flow rate, mass flow rate given, velocity at inlet given, power developed by turbine given. Now here, work done is found. See here, how work done is found. I isolate that. Now this is work done. Now this is therefore work done W equal to 12,000 kilowatt. In kilojoule per kg, And of course, enthalpy of gas at inlet given, enthalpy of gas at outlet given, velocity of gas, and you observe these units. These are in kilojoule per scale. And what is to be done in the equation? When we substitute in the equation, care has to be taken. See that care. See here for the problem again. Here the problem is I have just now told you that the gas turbine has to be drawn like this. See gas is enter here. That is at lower cross section or lowest cross section, and they leave out at the highest cross section. And there is a rotor, and because of the high energy gas center, the rotor rotates, and it rotates, and it will be coupled to a generator producing power. And here the gas is entered with high enthalpy and leave at low enthalpy. I told you enthalpy is checked. Enthalpy of gas at inlet is higher, and enthalpy of gas at outlet is lower. That means this enthalpy drop is utilized to produce power. So that is how power will be produced. And we take this as boundary, or boundary, or you can even take this as the entire the solid surface itself as a boundary, and the control wall will be inside. And all these are not required to show in the problem. However, just to understand a turbine, I repeat, a turbine is drawn like this, a divergent duct, like this, a divergent duct. You can show gases in, gases out like this, or enter from downside, leave from downside like this. You can show in any. But there is a heat rejection given, and there is a heat rejection, and in the problem you take the photography of this problem, because while I discuss the solution of the problem, you check the problem statement so that you will be familiarized how the numericals or parameters are to be substituted in the equation. You will be familiarized. So you take the photo of this problem, and see this is the problem, and I am now see. you are asked to find heat rejection. W is given, H1, H2 are given, C1, C2 given. So see here. Now see this is a best example to familiarize with units. And how to substitute these each and every one term in these equations, we can learn from this problem. So this is the equation, and here tell me on what basis this equation is written, per unit mass basis or total mass basis. Okay, if C1 square by 2, C2 square by 2 are there, there is no M. MC1 square by 2 is not there, MC2 square by 2 is not there. Like that, in that way you have to think over. Now tell me, on what basis the equation is written, for unit mass basis or total mass basis? What is the equation for kinetic energy? I am putting a question, respond. What is the equation for kinetic energy?
Half mv square.
Half into mv square.
Ah, right. Half into mv square. See, look at this this term. Half. C. Instead of V, we are assuming this, the velocity as C. Therefore, in half mv square, there is no m. If there is no m, then this equation is called as per unit mass basis equation, per unit mass. So if m is there, m is also there, and this small h is written as capital H, and the small q is small h is written as capital H again, at both at inlet and outlet. Then this is called a total on total mass basis. But here, because in your half mv square there is no m, it is therefore, because it is removed, the equation is called per unit mass basis, where each and every term will have the unit of joule per kg. Even meter by second square, we are calculating each and every term. H1 is of course given in the problem, 1260, and H2 is given as 400. And C1 given 50. Kinetic energy at inlet given as 50. So 50 square by 2. And here I told you this is joule per kg. Meter square per second square is also joule per kg. Because for example, how is meter square per second square is joule per kg? I asked you to multiply with the kg and divide by kg. So kg by kg, meter square per second square. So it will be kg meter per second square and one more meter per kg. So kg meter per second square is Newton, and Newton meter per kg. So Newton meter is joule per kg. In that way, meter square per second square is joule per kg. And here it is clearly written. So this is kg, kg by kg is added, and meter square by second. This is meter square by second, and kg meter per second square is Newton. 1 meter remain per kg. So joule per kg, because this is joule per kg, and because H1, H2, and W, that are. See here, the work done is worked out in kilojoule per kg. Kilojoule per kg. All the remaining units should be substituted with same kilojoule per kg to make C1 square by 2 into kilojoule per kg. This 1250 is divided by 1000. So it will be 1.25. kilojoule per kg. Similarly, C2 square by 110 square by 2000 directly written. So in the earlier equation, we have written these directly. Why? Because of all this story. So 110 square by 2 will be in joule per kg or Newton meter per kg. And if this is divided by 1000, the resultant will be in kilojoule per kg. Now, see, the kinetic energy at inlet and outlet are in kilojoule per kg. H1, H2 in kilojoule per kg. See, in the problem, see, H1, H2, 1260 kilojoule per kg, 400 kilojoule per kg. So they are given in kilojoule per kg. So because of that, C1 square by 2, because this is written in per unit mass base, and you will get only joule per kg. we divide this by 1000, and again we divide c2 square by 2, the value we divide by 1000 to make this as kilojoule per kg. Now we substitute c1 square by c2 square comfortably. Now h1 is substituted, c1 square by 2, 1.25 substituted. I asked you to write plus q so that the value will get negative. You will get negative value, meaning that heat is rejected. Now q is written, h2 400 given, c2 square by 2 6.05, and 800 is work done. Work done, see here, work done is 12,000 kilowatt divided by mass flow rate in kg per second. These are all given. So 12,000 by 15 is equal to 800 kilojoule per kg. So that is also to be substituted in kilojoule per kg. Now q will be in kilojoule per kg, and it is a negative value, meaning that this much heat is rejected from, see here, now heat rejected is written positive. Either numerically you call q is equal to minus 55 by 55.2 kilojoule per kg, or heat rejected you can say that heat rejected equal to 55.2 kilojoule per kg, or by multiplying with kg per second, that is mass flow rate that is flowing through the device, that in kg per second this kg gets cancelled and kilojoule per second remains, and this will be kilojoule per second will be kilowatt. So if you multiply by 15, you will get in kilowatt. This much power rejected in kilowatt. So now I ask you the second part of the problem. The second part of the problem is a little bit applicable for the second part, where area of the inlet pipe is for that you are given specific volume of gas settlement. So this requires continuity equation. That means mass flow rate in mass that is entering is rho A, that is density of gases multiplied by area of gas multiplied by velocity of gas, or AV, I am calling velocity as velocity C and velocity as V, or I call area into velocity into density, density into area into velocity, or area into velocity by specific volume. 1 by density is specific volume, and therefore density rho is written as 1 by V. Because why it is written, we are given with specific volume, we were given specific volume value in meter cube per kg, and mass flow rate equation m dot given. Now see, in this equation m dot equal to velocity into area by specific volume. See, the area is required. Area is required. And see, the value of velocities are also given. C1, C2 are given. But at inlet, we require area. So we are using inlet, at what inlet velocity the mass is entering? 6 meter per second. How much mass is entering? This is 15. M dot is how much? You see, check. M dot is 15 kg per second. 15 kg per second. That is 15 kg per second. So with that M dot, you use 15 here. That M dot and what is specific volume? The specific volume is 0.44. So this is, of course, you use your own numericals. Here mistakenly written, some mistakes are written here. So for m dot, you use 15 kg per second. For velocity c, c area equal to mv by c, mv by c. So this is 0.45, this is 15, and the area will be calculated at inlet. And at outlet also you can calculate area using same mass flow rate, and area can be formed. Like this, the areas can be. You check the problem. The specific volume of the gases at inlet given. So mass flow rate at inlet, the specific volume is given. So specific volume multiplied by kg per second, that is 15 kg per second, is mass flow rate m dot. Using the formula m dot multiplied by small v1 equal to m dot multiplied by small v2, you can find specific volume at outlet. At outlet, you will find at outlet the specific volume. See some here. You ignore these numericals. You substitute the correct numericals. M dot is 15. V1 is 0.45 given there, and V2 you can find using M dot into V1 equal to M dot into V2, or A1 C1 equal to A2 C1. Like that, V2 can be found. After finding V2, you substitute V2 here. And A2, that is area at outlet, can be found. All this is mathematical equation. Using this simple continuity equation, we calculate area. That's why I asked you to remember the continuity equation: mass flow rate as density into area into velocity, density into area into velocity, or area into velocity by specific volume, because density rho equal to 1 by specific volume. So rho is written as 1 by small. And in that way, we calculate the required parameters using this continuity equation, simple continuity equation. And here m dot given, c1 given, and v1 of course given for the inlet. For outlet, you can find this v2 by using m dot v1 equal to m dot v2. M dot v1 equal to m dot v2, or like that using continuity equation or discharge equation. We will show again, we will show. So in this way, a problem can be solved. The gas turbine problem can be solved. The very purpose of the continuity equation is to solve problems when given, and to substitute the correct numericals in the problems using correct numericals. You have to substitute in the steady flow energy equation. The steady flow energy equation. One of you tell me the steady flow energy equation. Just for the sake of your friends, what is the complete steady flow energy equation? Generalized steady flow energy equation. The steady flow energy equation is, may apply the steady flow energy equation on many devices like this. There may be in the coming process, there may be a heat exchanger may be considered, a compressor may be considered. Okay, in that way, any device, all this, all a pump may be considered like that. All these are steady flow devices. For all the devices, the only one generated equation steady flow energy equation applicable is, what is that steady flow energy equation? One of you recollect or read the equation written by you, the equation learned by us, because we may consider many problems and many devices in the coming session, but all those are dealt with only one simple steady flow energy equation. So in that equation, we are, if you understand that equation, you can apply that equation to any device. Sometimes unknowingly, suppose if the purpose of the device is not known by you, then also you can apply. See, the theory behind the problem, sometimes you need not know. Still, the steady flow energy equation can be applicable. So what is the steady flow energy equation? One of you, please recite, please recap. Steady flow energy equation. We have been dealing the steady flow energy equation from nozzle onwards. Okay, read the steady flow energy equation. It should be dynamic.
Sir, H1 plus C1 square by 2 equal to H2 plus C2 square by 2, sir.
See, this is not a generalized equation. Okay, steady flow energy equation applied to this device. But see, you missed some terms. See, for example, that's why I doubt. Why I put the question on you, because the generalized equation must be remembered. The very generalized equation must be remembered or must be recalled as and when required. The generalized equation I show you, this is the generalized equation. See, if you remove M, the generalized equation is U1 plus C1 square by 2. Is it visible to you? I am showing some equation with M.
Yes, sir.
Yes? Now,
yes, sir.
This is the generalized equation. This is the generalized equation. You can remove M sometimes and write U1 plus C1 square by 2 plus GZ1 plus T1V1. And of course, many times we use small q. We are showing, for understanding purpose, we are showing capital Q and capital W. But whenever written on mass basis, we have to write small q and small W here. Now, U1 plus C1 square by 2 plus GZ1 plus T1V1. Plus small q equal to U2 plus C2 square root plus GZ2 plus P2V2 plus small w. And where U1 plus P1V1 is H1. That's what you are telling, H1 plus C1 square root. You said you ignored this. But I asked you generalized equation. When you are telling the generalized equation, all these terms are, instead of U1 plus P1V1, you can either tell H1. H1 plus C1 square by 2 plus GZ1 over plus Q, small q, equal to either these terms, that is U2 plus P2V2 plus C2 square by 2 plus GZ2 plus small w, or instead of U2 P2V2, you can write H2, small h, H2 plus C2 square by 2 plus GZ2 plus w. All this equation has to be recorrected. That means the equation of potential energy, the equation of kinetic energy, and of course U and PV terms or H terms, only one, either u1 plus u1 u1 or small h1, only one. And with q1 w terms are also, these terms are also important to show the generalized equation. So whenever a generalized equation is asked, you have to recollect this. This equation, you have to every time recollect. And the terms are equated depending on the context. For example, z1 equal z2. So z1, gz1 is removed. Gz2 is removed. Sometimes q may be removed. There may be adiabatic device. So in that case, q may be removed. In that way, the steady flow energy equation has to be applied for different devices by recalling this equation. Not what you said is not a generalized equation. It is correct, equally correct, but not applicable all the times. Not applicable to all the devices all the times. So therefore, the only generalized equation which I have shown you is the generalized equation. For any device, we have to, you see, for example, for the turbine, I wrote this equation, but instead of this, you have to write h1 plus c1 square by 2 plus gz1 plus q equal to h2 plus c2 square by 2 plus gz2 plus w. That, of course, always use small q and small w, not as it is shown here, because at the beginning, just to have to make you familiarize with the heat and work terms, using capital letters for heat, capital Q, and for work, capital W. But it should not be done, it should not be the case in general. It is small Q and small W when for unit mass basis the equation is written, or when on total mass base, basis, if you write, then the equation we have shown is which I have shown can be it can be considered as. Okay, I will show you. Just now, see, this is per unit mass basis, and you have to use small q, small w only, and whenever this is written on absolute mass basis, you can write this as q dot w dot. That means putting a dot over q, a dot over w, where this is m dot. M dot, m, a dot shown over m, so that w will be in watts, joule per second, and like that. In that way, the terms have to be shown. Okay, here at this point, we will stop. Okay, thank you.